hands, dukes up, elbows in, back heel up, abs a brace, 60%, 40%, yeah? So we've got the uppercut sequence where we do, I think it's like 5, and then 7, and then 9, and 11, and 15, so we just, you know, for a whole kind of like minute and a half or something like that, that's kind of what we do, yeah? Don't forget, I mean, moving your arms is great because, you know, you're moving your arms. That's about the only great thing about it. But what I want you to do is twist more. So let the twist power up your punch as well as your arms powering up the punch. So you can go like this or you can go like this, yeah? The punch is actually gonna be a lot easier and less awkward if you actually move your spine a little, just like this. It's not awkward to do that. And it's gonna be less awkward to punch if your spine, the twisting, can help that punch go forward, yeah? It's gonna be less awkward. So doing it on their own is hard. Doing it with your core, it's just a lot more easier. And you're burning a lot more calories, yeah? There is also a sequence right in the middle before we flip over to the left combat stance, where we just do them running, 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 running. Now, Dan states, if you don't wanna do the running, you can do the marching. Holy shit. Do not ever give that option, man. If you want it harder during that sequence, then your knees go higher. If you want it easier during that sequence, then your knees go lower. That is such a good time. I mean, we're there to do body combat. We're there to get power and rah. We can do everything, yeah? We're not there to kind of like an old man going, might as well offer him a walking stick as well.